Welcome back. And I think you having enough time to understand the project this time, what we have done in previous three videos. So in this last video, we have to design this section, that is the footer part of the Facebook. We look at this, it should look like this. Okay, so here again, we are not taking this as this contain JavaScript concept, so I'm just only using this portion over here. So here we go with this. So for this, I have to go to the Facebook file, and this tip over here, and this has started from here. Now if we see the all div is closed over there, now we have to write the section for the footers. So we have to start with div, and within this div we have to write two section here, and to save our time, as we see over there, we can make this link English UK, then Hindi, Punjabi, this Urdu, with this Kannada, with this over here Malayalam, and all these things. So for this we need to have special keyboard setting. So what I have done, I have already copied this line available for me, so I'm just copying this from here. So this is my first line. I'm just copy C, copy this from here, and we have to paste it over here. Okay, we have to paste it over here. So save this, and here we go, refreshing of the file. Now look at this. This is written over there, so we have to style this. Then we are having another line over there. So first we will start with this. So for this we have to go to the style sheet for styling of this footer. So here we go, creating a ID, say footer underscore wrapper, footer underscore wrapper here. So for this we need to have width, width 100%, and we just want to clear. Now as we see over here, if you see this, so we wanted to clear it from both side. Okay, so for this reason I write here clear both, then I want it to float left, then here I need to have margin over here. If you see this margin, so here I have to set margin for this margin. This is margin top, so I just want to set it around 30 pixel, and the minimum width for this is 995 pixel for this section, and background color, here we see the, if we see over here, the background color is white, so for that hexadecimals, so this is white color here, and text align, I want to, as we see over there, text is aligned left. Okay, So I have to apply this over here. So here we have to apply it to this dev ID. ID equal to footer underscore wrap. We just apply this ID, go here and refresh it. Okay, now it's done over there. You see this. Okay, now we are to again go for the second line that is written over there. So here we have to create another ID with the name of footer, and here we write width, say 980 pixel, margin 0 or auto, then we have to set padding. Here we want say 0 pixels, then we have to set, we see over here, is there any, yes, it's having border, so we set border 1 pixel. So there is no border here. If we go down here we see this. Okay, look at this. So this is border at bottom. So what we have to set here, we have to set border bottom of 1 pixel, and it's solid 1 pixel solid, and for this I have to select color. So for this I'm clicking the color E6. So this color I have selected for the border. Then we go line height. For this we have to give the line height, so I'm giving it around 30 pixels. Then font size, if we see over this, the font size is around 12 pixel. Font size of 12 pixel, and color here used is somewhat matching the gray. So for this I'm using color scheme hash 848484. Okay, so save this. Now refresh it. Nothing is going to happen over here, so we have to apply this ID. So this ID I'm applying over here, ID, the name of the ID is footer. So save this now and refresh. Now this is applied. Now here we see this is showing as V link, and links are underlined over here and there is no space among them, so that we need to set a style over here in CSS. For this we have to write hash footer, and within the footer we have to use anchor, and here we have to set, say, first text decoration we wanted to have none. So text decoration we need not to be have there, and this has to be displayed as inline. Display inline, then margin we have to set for the wrap. Now there is no space among this, so we have to set margin to the left. That is around 10 pixel. And here we specify color. If we see the color, if you go there and see the color, it's somewhere something like blue. Okay, so we just go here and set the color. For this we use hash 3658 3658 99. Okay, so then save this and here we go, refresh this. So this is, it's achieved now. Now here we have to give the hover effect. If we see over there, is showing hover effect when we moving a mouse point, it's going to be under. So for this we have to write here hash footer, then a colon hover, then here we have to write text decoration under line. Save this, refresh here, or see. So this is set over there. This is set over there. So now we are left with another footer. So in this, we have to insert another line there. So here we go. Then take another div. And in this line, we have to insert these all. So as we see, all these are the links. Okay, all these are the links. So I have already copied to save our time. So we just go to home. This is simple way of creating a link. So I'm just copying this, and here in this portion I'm just going to paste it, save it, and here we go. Refresh it. Now it's all set. It's all set. So now we have to style it. So for this we will go to style.css file, and here we create another ID. Instead of creating this ID, I'm just copying these code. Control C and paste it here and give the name to this as 1. Save this. Now apply this to this div ID footer 1. Control S, refresh this. This is saved over here. Now here is, we have to remove the underline and we have to give the spacing among them. So for this we have to go to CSS, and here we have to write hash here. We again, I'm just copying the same code over here because this is going to be repeated here. So Control C, here we copy this. So this time it's footer 1 dot anchor. Here we want text decoration none, then display line and margin to the left. Here we have to set small margin. Say I'm just putting it around 1 pixel. And to this I'm saying, putting this color. Okay, same color is there. And here we have to add another text decoration none, and here we have to specify minimum width. So here I'm specify 80 pixel. Now save this. Here we go, refresh this. Now it's almost done over here. Now we have to go with the hover effect. So in this case we just take it as around 10 pixel. Save this, refresh it. Now this much space is required over here. Then water burn, then we have to give the hover effect to this. So here we are not getting hover effect, so here I have given footer one dot. So save this. Sorry, here we have to click and save this, and here we go refresh this. Now look at this, the hover effect is applied to this. Okay, so if we look at this, this is almost created there. So this way we have created a project that is clone of Facebook. In this we have created 4 videos to accomplish this job. So one more trick that I would like to discuss with you over here. So if we see, this is a small file that is having only lines around 50 lines. If we go to styling of this file, then if we see, this is a big file in our case. Okay, so what we can do, we can reduce the size of this file. Just simply we have to do, we have to make separate all these things. Okay, from here we have started our footer. So what we can do, we can cut this code from here and go to a file, and then we will select a new file, and here we paste this code and save this file. Here we have to select CSS, and the name I will give to is as style 1. Save this. Now similarly you can cut this code from where we have started our this. Control X and go to file and new file and save this file. Extension CSS and give the name to this file as style 2. Save this. What we have to do, we have to, now if we see over there, we have created 3 files over here. One is style, second is the style 1 and style 2. So now this is having small size, and whenever we have to modify this file, so we can have idea and we can easily modify over there, as the file size is big and messy. So it will become difficult to find out the errors and rectify those. So we can make them small size simply in the section. But we have to do, we have to make some changes in the header section. So here we have to go and select this and copy this, and here we go, and here just give the name as style 1, and here give the name as style 2. So in this case we have created 3 external style sheet files, CSS files, and we have linked those files to this HTML files. Okay, so same job can be accomplished using this. So if we go and refresh this, nothing is going to be changed. It means to say that these files are working. So this way we can accomplish this course. So that's all for now. I hope you will be able to understand the project that we have done, and it will make your doubt clear about CSS and HTML. Thank you so much. Best of luck.